crowd just building here, but we have the roof closed in Vancouver and BC Place, and a very fast track here today. France kicking off to their left. Gathered by the Argentinians.
Roll.
Initial penalty to Argentina. French not rolling away there. Nice first touch for the men in blue and white. Stumbling run through the middle. Really efficient by the Argentinians. We'll see this all weekend. Happy to hold on to the ball. The commentator's jinx. But the French are offside midfield.
One. Del Mestre was the one there.
One.
They spread it across the field and finally took it into contact. It was a good contact too. It was a good, quick, clean ball. And unfortunately for France, just offside again defensively.
Well, that man in the middle, he's the playmaker. 35 years young, Rival. He handles it a couple of times. Usually it's good news for Argentina as they go through here. Luciano Gonzalez going to the corner, but the final pass is deemed forward.
No. You can't, and it's forward.
Was Gonzalez again with a nice strong run. That's the forward pass. Hard to see on that angle. He was away for sure.
Yeah.
On the outside, that's twice. Yeah. He's gone through the hole.
Well, with Gonzalez's power, I'm surprised maybe he had a chance to keep that flat over the line. He was so impressive last week in Singapore. Has an eye for the line, but pass in question there. So, France dodged the ball for the moment. Referee's just going to take his time to reset this scrum. I don't know how our Kiwis, French and Spanish is, Carl.
Yeah, it's Carl. So they're still trying to figure it out on those yell. Telling him to allow him to get the binder right there is not to let him do it. So
he needs to go over, okay? So you need to let him. Yes. You let him this one, okay? You let him or free kick? Yes.
So for those who don't think the seven scrum is competitive, there is a lot going on up there. We'll keep an eye on it this weekend. Because there were a few against the head last week in Singapore, really rare in the sevens game. Well, look at that hooker position, though. It's a shocker for the French, but they do get the ball away. They go with the flow. And out wide, a little bit of space. Real gas, great pace from Epe. He's done it right from his own try line. Nelson Epe starts our weekend in Vancouver with a glorious full-length try for France. 5-0.
It's a great sequence play right from the get-go. They're right on their line. It was a good scrum. They got it out. It was a nice hit up by Grand Didier. And from there, quick tilt. And I like the way he just backs himself. He uses his swerve on the outside on Gaston Rival. And there it shows the emotion as you get with the French. That's a great start.
Yeah, he's one of these dual threats they've got with Jordan Cepho. Toulouse, man. Extras are added. Epe, only 21 years old, but has a nose for the try line and loves seeing that much space the Argentinians gave him.
Down on the scoreboard.
Well, I think they know now they can't give him any more space because he will jam them on the outside, so that's a warning already.
Kickoff again gathered by the Vumas. Off they go through East Grove. Just about 9 o'clock in the morning here in Vancouver, so an early start for both these teams. Del Mestre brought down midfield illegally, said the referee, or the entry. Quick spin from Wade. On his toes is Luciano Gonzalez, and again the ball's spilled, and he's going to be offside there ahead of the knock-on.
We talk about the early start. You see, now the second wind's starting to come in. Guys are starting to fatigue halfway through this first half, so this is the moment now that France really need to take control.
That's been an issue for them, their game management, as we said. No problem scoring the try. Tries on the board. Discipline an issue. Leading the series with yellow cards. I think it's 15 for the season. So that's something that Jerome Darrieu will have spoken about this week. Into space. For the moment. Iragua, is he going to get enough to get there? Just a handoff. William Iragua, second try for France.
Well, the Argentinians invited them into that, didn't they? From the offside play. And this guy. He has taken over the role of Teddy Brouwer as the playmaker in this French side. And William Egrua just showing that he can finish from deep as well. So a couple of long-range tries from Le Bleu.
Sure player.
Yeah, this is his ninth World Series event. The 24-year-old relishing his role there.
Shall we kick behind halfway?
Good strike. And a little warning there for the kickoff. And there you see Gerald Darre. A little warning for his kicker to stay behind the halfway line.
I haven't seen him for a while. 2 years. It looks like an easy haircut, my mate. Played against Jerome for a number of years. Great, great coach.
Well, a great time for French rugby right now. Current Grand Slam champions in Europe. And their sevens team looking to do a little bit better than last week. That ninth place finish we mentioned in Singapore. More possession for the Argentinians, but they have nothing to show for it at the moment. It's less than 2 minutes to play. Oh, big hit there. Iscro still down on the ground. Hopefully he's okay. Rogel scrapping as he always does.
From you and
trying to get the turnover. There's going to be an accidental knock. There's the big hit there. Rogel.
Oh, these hits to be had in the game of sevens. You can time it. He just gets... A little bit upright, does Lozell, but I'm with you, Gareth. One of the hardest working forwards in the game. Unfortunately, there through the counter ruck, just knocked it on a little bit.
Former Olympian from Rio in 2016. And 74 times he started his Saturday morning with a rugby game on the HSBC World Series. Not a bad life, eh?
I'm sure there's no complaints whatsoever, but he's got to hold up this side of the scrum right now. France, one more opportunity to score before the half. Oh no, free kick.
So more problems at the scrum.
Fire away, yeah.
This girl's going to be brought back, didn't go through the mark. Rivol knows his need. The side needs something here in the dying minute of this first half here. Seatbelt tackle over the shoulder, not allowed. Off goal of the Argentinians, trying to up the tempo a little bit here. Around the corner again goes Iscro. He's been busy in this first half. Again, the one-handed offload out the back door doesn't go to anyone.
That's the defense I'm sure Coach Darre will be talking about. As the playmaker, William Kagruha, the try scorer, getting over there, the little man, making a nuisance of himself, and he calls that turnover. That's a good 7 minutes first half, because it's a very competitive pool, Gareth.
Yeah, it is. Obviously, Ireland and Scotland are coming this one. The Argentinians, as their standings, you see how both France and Argentina top eight at the moment. The Argentinians have 3 bronze medals this season, and a silver to show for their work on the World Series. French don't have any, but this is a little bit of an upset in the making if the French can build it. And they're going to kick it off the park to end the first half with that 2-try advantage. So at the end of the first half here in Pool D, it's France 12, Argentina 0. Gaston Rivol for Argentina. The low flat kick. Well gathered by Grand Didier. There's a hint of an overlap there, but good line speed in the middle. Snuffs it out for the moment. There's the inside ball. Support still coming. Riva backing up. They get it out wide now. This is Grand Didier. Back in a one-on-one situation. Steps inside, driving the legs. Good support inside. Does he get over the line? Referee's going to have a look.
No. Timo. Try yes or no.
I'll tell you what, he was right there, Nick Hogan. He was in the best position than anyone. Good scrambling D. Oh, try time. Ooh, geez, was it? I'll give that. I reckon
that's okay. The referees have changed it a bit. We used to talk about maybe downward pressure. It's actually contact with the ball, I believe. It's what they're looking for. For those of you new to rugby, the television match official, the referee's going to access.
For me, the timing was good of tackle. Okay, we're just checking grounding.
The referee's going to ask to check the grounding upstairs so the TV booth, the TV crew will look at it and give him feedback through his earpiece there, you see.
Nick?
Yes.
There is no try.
The left hand,
there is separation. The ball was lost forward.
No try. Lock on.
Well, there you go. That's one of the great pieces of the World Series. You got to hear it. No try as it was lost forward. So he's deemed there wasn't consistent contact with the ball.
Yeah, I think the left hand. there of the playmaker. William Grua. This guy got it all started in Grand Didier. He's backed up nicely, but just this. Yeah. Good call.
Crouch.
So.
Bind.
The Argentinians haven't lost, as you can see, in the last five matches. They're on the ropes at the moment. And usually when they are, they look to that man, Revol, to create something. He goes to the short side, sucks the French defense all the way over to the touchline. Fairly slow ruck ball. What anyone wants in the sevens game. He scores again. And they've been penalized. Quick tap. A meter out. This time held up again. Uruguay. Stepping back, Logel says, let's take this up. Let's get a platform to work from. Argentine player has really no chance to roll away, so he's been penalized.
Yeah, that was a great turnover by Sefo, I think it was, from France. But France weren't employing a sweeper, so they had seven men up in the line. That's why Argentina were finding it hard to clear their line.
A couple of penalties there in the last minute, putting Argentina under pressure. Uruguay is wisely slowing the game down with his 12-point lead. Come back fairly tight. Oh, fantastic defense from the Argentinians. To a man stepping up, and they've won the ball. Can they turn defense into offense? Off goes Gonzalez, the bulldog, as Santiago
offside.
Calls
ball
him.
Not out.
The French guilty of sinking up the side. They're offside. Argentina, 5 minutes to go. They need something to show for their efforts. You're a referee, short advantage in the sevens game. Oh, but not the first time today. Argentina, ball with the ball.
Oh, just a pass in behind again, that's fatigue. It's the second tournament, remember, for these teams. It's early on in the day, but they put an absolute shot on defense. Non-committal, really, that French attack, and they got absolutely smoked for the... Del Mestre, he can put a shot on.
He got a pass to the eyeball, and then he got that shot. But that's when the Argentinians are good. They're really aggressive.
Yeah, and they go forward. I think there's something just in attack. Not having that fluency in defense, they seem okay pretty much generally. But attack-wise, they just got to sort that out. Ugarte is onto the field. He can go too.
I'm on. Crouch!
4.5 minutes here in the second half. Full the action. Tons of time in the sevens game. And France up 12-0 at the moment. This will be a big victory for them if they can hold on.
Ruck form, second crack.
The ruck was formed, so no hands allowed.
Yeah, they're getting desperate now, aren't they? And that's why this ill discipline's coming in from this Argentinian
second
team. They need to get that out. They got
second crack.
They're getting frustrated because they haven't had any chance with the ball, and the French team, to their credit, have slowed it down, setting up their play.
Again, good refereeing. Nicole getting aware of the tactics, know that France are happy to let that clock tick away, but he wants to give the fans something to watch here. Uruguay tries to put it through on the left boot. Doesn't get full contact, so Argentina have a chance here. Not sure about that tactic, KT, but they've given the ball right back.
Oh, they shouldn't have kicked it away. Now, Argentina, this is the moment in this game. If they're going to make a comeback, it has to be from here.
Argentina, full complement of backs. Through the hands they go. A show and go from the big man. Off the bench, Hermann Schultz. There's a gap right through the middle. Just snuffed out, but a tidy offload. Revol keeps the play going. Argentina 22 meters out now. Moneta going for the corner. How many times have we seen that? The hand goes up. The foot's not in touch. Marcos Moneta, try for Argentina.
Yeah, the big guns have come off the bench for this Argentinian team, and they needed to, and it come from a nice pass. Watch this from Del Mestre. That is absolutely brilliant. To Revol, the skipper, and this guy we know. He can score a try. He's got gas, he's got power, he's got RG back in this one.
He just has a nose for the line, doesn't he, KT? World Rugby Sevens Player of the Year. Has a real passion for this game and knows how to score.
Oh, right from the get-go when we first saw him in the Olympics. You're right, Reese. He can score tries and he can score them in multiple ways, and Argentina definitely need it. And now the momentum shifts definitely on the Puma side.
The conversion was missed, so 7 points. How important is this kickoff? We're about to find out.
Massive, absolutely massive. It's just such an important part of the game. The restarts has to go 10. There's a bare minimum. So that's a lost opportunity. And what it does is hand the ball back to France.
France controlling the tempo, as you see. They're using their own subs. That's Mazzolini. Simple set piece. They'll be looking to get lots of numbers over the ball. Maintain possession. Dancing around is Uyao. He goes backwards. Mazzolini brought down Uyao immediately there. Rivage. He places back, and the Argentinians not supporting their own weight.
Oh, that was unlucky too. They got isolated at the breakdown. It just went to his hands, elbows to the ground. You can't do that at the ruck.
Yeah, it looked like he had a shot at it, didn't it? They're very strict on that. Again, Argentina looks like they're just really trying to wind the clock down. Big tackle, midfield from Schultz. Inexplicably throwing the ball backwards and where there's no support, the French get just enough there to keep possession. Dancing around is Grandidi. He's had a lot of touches in this game. Full width for France, as you can see. You can hear in our effects mic from the referee just how the pace of this early on. There's a lot of panting out there from ref and players. Argentina just going through the phases at the moment. 30 seconds to play here. Regulation time. That's a risky pass. It's on the ground. He's tackled. He must release and get to his feet. Referee says he didn't. Argentina ball. 5 meters out.
Thank you.
Quick tap.
Cannot be in front of the five.
Quick tap again behind the five. Going for the line, Luciano Gonzalez, a meter short, advantage being played. And over, quick pick from Bazan Velez. Argentina has scored, and significantly Carlton Anna under the post.
Oh yeah, makes it so much easier for conversion. Here's just the back end of it with Bazan Velez, but it all started with the numbers. Number one,
no, no.
Let's go get in the turnover.
Cannot touch. No, you cannot touch. Out.
So there it is. The extras to tie it up. Our first pool match here in Vancouver is a draw. 12 points apiece, Argentina and France in Pool D.